I think it's time we play the first song. What do you guys say?
Yeah, the first one we're going to play is World War III. This is a clip of it, so get ready.
World War III.
They're going to hear it. We're not, but just...
Okay. Well, we'll just sit here quietly. We can't hear it. There's only one black body, if you know. Whoa, that this lesson's left alone. Every time you attack, I can try me to fight you back. And then I know, whoa, that I'll never let it be. World War III.
Awesome.
Wow.
So yeah. I'll tell you a little bit about that song first. That's a song that I wrote about a relationship that I was in at one point where it was a very one-sided argument. Mm. It's like, no need to fight because you're the only one fighting. And so that's how that song came about. And it's a prime example of the horns that we're trying to infuse on this next record, and we'll be playing you more songs that have that same similar sound.
Can you do one of the horn hits from that song, guys?
Be a little loud if we're this close.
Yeah.
We'll save it for the live show.
We'll save it for the live show. Never mind. It'll be like ear bleed and stuff.
Alright guys. Thank you for
Thank you very much, guys. Wave to everybody. We will see you on the World Tour. If you're not guys, if you don't have your tickets yet, make sure to grab your tickets to that because you're gonna see all these people having a blast. And of course, Jordan Sparks and Honor Society playing on the shows as well. It's gonna be amazing. Thanks guys.
Cool. Yay.
We will see you tomorrow at rehearsals. Have a great evening.
Alright, guys. I had a good story.
Back to your cages.
Thanks, Joe.
Back to your cages.
Are you gonna be at the same time tonight?
Okay, the comments are rolling in. The first song, they
love it. What do you think? Sweet song.
What do you think? They said that was what...
Oh. Peace out.
Peace out. Where are you leaving? Oh. Oh, to them. Not they're
oh,
not
gotcha. And about the song, because it's World War III. It's peace.
Yeah.
Can you say, I love you, Harley? Oh, I love you.
Oh, they're like, no, don't leave.
She's got a picture of her in, like, Garbo, I think.
That's cute.
Garbo.
Have you...
Cultures, I think.
Have you learned any new cultures? Funky like Stevie Wonder, that comment says.
Wow.
I still think the Dreads are the best.
Wow, Ryan.
Ryan!
Ryan's getting some serious love.
Please say hi to Amanda in Aloha.
Hi.
Could you please wish Dia and Palak happy birthday?
I'm so pumped about this. I know we talked about the movie a little while before, but the little guest appearance we were able to make in Night at the Museum 2. There's a song in the end credits. If you haven't seen the movie, make sure to go check it out, because this song is a song that we wrote, and then it ended up working out great for the movie.
Mm-hmm.
And we actually just released it on our Radio Disney last night, and the response from that you guys have was unbelievable. So we're going to play a clip of that song right now.
This is actually my favorite song on the record. It's a great song. It's a great song. I really like it, I mean. And it's just, I enjoy it because it talks about, you know, what we go through, like traveling and being away from people that you love.
So this song is called Fly With Me. Here's a little clip for you guys.
Here you go.
Leave it all behind. It's you and me forever. It's you and me right now. That'd be
there you go.
Cool. Wow.
That is the little clip that you guys get of a song called Fly With Me. That is actually part of Night at the Museum 2 in the end credits.
So you can go check that out in theaters now. And pick up the album June 16th, right? Oh, this is actually a question. Peter Pan and Wendy turned out fine, so won't you fly with me? Yeah.
Peter Pan is one of my favorite Disney stories of all time.
Peter Pan's the man.
It actually, the Peter Pan theatrical version
rhyming
is one of the things that got me inspired to be in musical theater at first when I was a lot younger. And so we were writing a song with our bass player, Greg Garbowski. And basically, the chorus came about and it fit perfectly. And it just made sense because it's such a great story, the love story between Peter Pan.